With all the different video capture devices that are available today, creative people have more tools than ever before to create some really interesting high quality videos. So for instance, I found this one that was shot from the front cabin of a train. Now, this is a pretty cool video, but there's also a pretty simple way that we can make this video, as well as many other videos, even more engaging, and that's to add some music to it. So let's go ahead and do that. I'm just gonna drag this track down, drop it here, and let's see how that sounds. Okay, so that's not bad. I think the music definitely adds something to this video. But if I was a more skilled editor, if maybe I had some more time, I can make this even better by trying to line up the really interesting parts of this video to interesting parts of the music as well. So for instance, at the very beginning of the video, when the train goes from a standstill to moving, it'd be nice if the music kind of did something interesting at this point. But unfortunately, that's not what happens. And later on, when the train goes into this tunnel, it'd be nice if the music also had some kind of corresponding change. But unfortunately, there's not a lot of interesting stuff going on in the song right now. And finally, when the train bursts out of the tunnel back into the daylight, that's another opportunity for something really dramatic to happen in the music. But again, no dice. So it'd be really great if we could get all these interesting moments to line up with really interesting points in the music as well, while still sounding like a single continuous song. But that is an extremely difficult thing to do manually with existing tools. So to address this, we've developed an algorithm that automatically generates a seamless version of the song that hits all of these musical change points at the specified times. Now, as Kim mentioned, this is related to the new remix feature in Audition that you saw at the keynote yesterday. But while remix focuses on retargeting just the length of a song, here we focus on trying to hit all these different change points at the specified times. So let me just go ahead and run our algorithm on this track. And you'll see it will analyze the song for a second, and then it'll generate a new version of the song. And I can just go back into Premiere, and then just import it. And now, let's just drop that imported track directly underneath the video. And you'll notice I'm not doing any editing here, I'm just dropping it straight down. But now, when we go back to those different interesting points in the video, you'll see that something interesting is also happening in the music. So for instance, at the beginning of the song, at the beginning of the video, when the train starts moving, that's right when the beat kicks in. And then later on, when we go into the tunnel, the music changes to a more down-tempo section. And then finally, when we burst out of the tunnel, back into the daylight, there's a really big build-up and a drop. Different points in the video, but of course the important thing is that it hits all those points but still sounds like a single continuous song. So let me just play the whole video from the beginning so you can hear how it all sounds together. For a lot of editing tasks, and we hope to get it onto your hands and see what you do with it soon.
I've got one question for you. That's amazing, and I think what's on all of our minds is, once you get it developed, Project Boxcar, will it work on other things besides train?
No, just on train.
Did you have something else in mind?
Well, I don't know. I was thinking maybe just a bicycle or...
Maybe next year.
Okay.